guys how to make your own custom thumbnail. First, you gotta download GIMP. And, you just gotta go into GIMP. But you gotta download it. The download will be in the description so you guys can use it. Because, yeah, this is the best thing you could use to make your own custom thumbnail. Just let it load. And also, you'll have to install Minecraft Skin Viewer. So what you're going to do is you're going to click File and New. Then, you're going to change the width to 1280 and change the height to 720. Click OK. Then you'll have this rectangle, I guess. And what you're going to do is you're actually going to go over to Layers here, and you're going to right-click it and delete it. After that, you're going to go into Minecraft Skin Viewer. And, yeah, the download for that will be in the description so you guys can use it so that you can, put your Minecraft skin, on the thumbnail. So, after you got that, you're going to put in your username. Mine is LocatLove. 1524. I'm just going to spell skin. Yeah, I don't have any capitals, do I? Yeah, well, since I already did this, you can just, go like this, make your skin however you want, go like that, and such. And I'm just gonna use my own, one that I have. I call it Good Cat Road, 1524. And you're just gonna pull it and drag it in. So now you got that, and if you want to make it smaller, you could just right click and do scale layer. And I'm going to make myself my 450 by 450 and scale it. So after you got that, what you're going to do, don't click 4. Sorry guys. That is just a zoom. Okay, but anyways, I can get a zoom if I want, but whatever. So after that, you got your face, correct? You got yourself. Now, you're going to go onto Google, and once you go onto Google, you're just going to search up, okay, ready? Minecraft title. Template, okay? You're gonna look up Minecraft title template, and it should show up a bunch of Minecraft stuff, and you can do Minecraft PE title template, and I have Minecraft and Minecraft Pocket Edition. You're just gonna pull it in, and it's gonna be like that. You could just scale it so that's smaller, and I'm just gonna scale it, and then you can move it to wherever you want. I mostly put it up onto the top of my screen. You don't have to. And then, after you got that, you can, choose a background or put, text. So, when I put in text, I make it about, 70, 60, and I choose the text I want. You can download custom text. I don't, but I just... So I use sans bold italic most of the time. Then you can choose the color. Make it a blue color here. There we go. Right, okay. Sorry for my scratchy voice. So you just go click and type in whatever you want. I'm just gonna type in thumbnail, because this is a custom thumbnail, so it's good to type in thumbnail, I guess. So again, you can move it around, and you're just going to go to filters, here, it's going to be up here. You're going to do light and shadow, hover over it, and then go to drop shadow. Then it's going to pop up something like this. You're going to put the opacity to whatever you want. And if you do not want to resize, just uncheck this and click OK. Then it's going to make it pop out more. And I'm going to do that with the girl cat mode as well. And you can do it with whatever you want. I'm not going to do it to my Minecraft. Actually, I'll do it. But when you do your Minecraft, it's a good idea to actually not allow resizing for it. And just click OK. So there we go. Then, you can do here is you could choose a background, and I'm actually going to go into Minecraft screenshot here, and yeah, take this nice one I got and pull it in. Now, you just like okay. Whoops, did not mean to do that. Then, you're going to put this layer down all the way. You're just going to click that and click down. But you also have to resize it and just do 1280 by 720, and there we go. Then you can lift these layers up. So so you can see yourself and stuff. And again, if this is not working, mine isn't, you could just go to layer, stack, and layer to bottom, so that it's at the bottom and you can see everything else. Now you can go to filters while you're on the background. You're gonna go to filters, light and shadow, and click on lens flare. This way it will make it look much nicer, and you can choose wherever you want it to be. I personally would put it right here, and click OK, and then it just renders lens flare. You could just let it do that, and so it's finished. And once it is, look at that! You have your own custom thumbnail. And if you guys enjoyed, be sure to click that like button. Subscribe for subscription for your friends, and yeah, definitely give this a like. And if this helped, yeah, give it a like. And yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Oh guys, and I almost forgot, to save it to anything that you want, you have to go to file and do export as, so that's a PNG image, so that you could use it. And I like to put it onto desktop, and I'm just going to call it, you can call it whatever you want. I'm just going to call it thumbnail. So yeah, that's how you do it, and you just click export, and then you click export again, and then it will go on ahead and go to your desktop screen. And once it is fully exported, you just gotta wait a little while. Okay, now it's fully exported. You just gonna click X, discard changes, put out a GIMP, and there it is. So there's your thumbnail, and you can put it on your video. So see you guys next time.